Chikara is a Bollinger & Mabillard dive coaster at Busch Gardens Tampa Bay in Tampa, Florida. It was built in 2005 and was America's first dive coaster. Nowadays, we see practically every dive coaster with an Immelmann after the first drop. However, this was the first B&M dive machine to do that. This coaster has become an icon for Busch Gardens Tampa. You can see it for miles and it's really intimidating for the GB. However, I'm gonna be perfectly frank, this is probably the most boring coaster I've ridden. It's so stupid. But before we start, let's run over a few quick stats. It has a height of 200 feet, a speed of 70 miles an hour, and has a length of 3,188 feet. It also has a duration of 53 seconds and has one inversion. So with all that said, let's begin. Chikara is located in the Stanleyville section of Busch Gardens Tampa Bay. It sits right across from Tigris and it dominates over the area. It is really tall and it just looks menacing over everything surrounding it. Now let me put you on my shoes. I'm coming all the way from Chicago and the only dive coaster I've ridden is Valraven, and every single person I've heard from says it's much better than that ride. In fact, some say it's even better than the sister dive coaster, Griffin at Busch Gardens Williamsburg, when Griffin is taller, faster, and it has more inversions. So considering I really liked Valraven, I had high hopes for this ride. I knew it wouldn't be better than Kumba or Montu, but that it would be a close number 3. It gets a long line even with the quick queue. I waited 30 minutes for this ride, so I can't even imagine how long the normal queue is. The station is tall, and you have to go over these bridge-type things to get to your row. Like, instead of having railings to separate all the different rows, you just go over one of the 3 bridges. I rode in the back row, so I went to the farthest one. It has a dual loading platform, so they are constantly pumping the train to this ride. Like the rest of the park, everything has a theme of African stuff and it has a jungle type vibe to it. So without any further ado, let's jump into the ride layout. You depart the station and dip to the right, going into the 200 foot lift hill. After your quick ascent, you make an 180 degree turn into your drop. As with all other dive coasters, this one hangs you over to the drop for a few seconds. You get a great view of the bright red twisting track and the deep blue supports, which by the way, this coaster has one of my favorite color schemes. Then after a few seconds, you drop. I will say, with those classic over the shoulder restraints, you do get more airtime than the vest restraints, but not much. The amount of airtime you get is definitely overhyped. I sure got airtime, but it's nothing like what I've heard. You get floater for a few seconds and bottom out, giving you a good dose of positive G's. You slowly but surely ascend into this massive Immelmann, giving you tons of hang time. Although this hang time doesn't even compare to the Heartline Roll on Tigris, it's still great. Then you twist up and spiral into the mid-course. Yeah, that's the first half. Only a few elements. You slow to a crawl before descending your second drop. This one really gives you great ejector. I'd probably say it's my favorite part of the ride. You dive down into a tunnel and go into an extremely drawn out turn. Kinda like how Taylor describes Dota Jumbo's turn, you physically feel the train slowing down. It's that drawn out. In my opinion, this is where the ride dies. You then dip into the splashdown. This, in a way, acts as a brake. There are these tube-like funnels on the train that scoop up water and thrust it into the air. This slows the train down a tiny bit. I thought I would feel the train slow down as we glided over the water, but I didn't. It felt like we were gliding on straight track. I'm sure it does slow the train down, but you certainly can't feel it. You then ascend into an extremely drawn out helix. Instead of ending with an intense helix, this one is so drawn out, it's stupid. Like, you just want it to be over. You get bored going through such a forceless element. Following the helix, you glide into the final breaks. This ride appeals to GP and to GP only. They find this ride terrifying, whereas with us thusies, we find it gimmicky. This ride wasn't designed to please us coaster enthusiasts. However, no ride is designed to. Us coaster enthusiasts make up a very small percentage of their revenue. So did they make a ride that impresses and thrills the GP? Yes. Is it fun? Eh, yeah, I guess. It's better than nothing, but it's definitely not my favorite coaster in the world. This ride is fun, I'll give it that. The drops give good airtime, and the inversion gives good hang time. But all the elements in between are extremely forceless and drawn out. If they replaced the drawn out turns and curves with inversions or tighter turns, this ride would be amazing. But I know that Busch would never do that because it's just unreasonable and far-fetched. So we're stuck with a kind of fun, kind of stupid ride that is Chikara. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you're new here, be sure to like the video and subscribe for more content just like this. See you guys in the next video. Goodbye.